Hi. As promised, we'll now discuss the dry extrusion process and the benefits of extruded full-fat soy. The dry extrusion process was developed by Triple F Inc. in the mid-1960s to enable farmers and producers in the Midwestern US to process whole soybeans that could be fed directly to livestock and poultry. Some of the objectives of its development were the simplicity of extruder operation, safety, the nutritional consequences of the process, low capital investment and operational costs, and the versatility of the machine in processing other grains and complete feed. The dry extrusion process allows flexibility in tailoring plant design to the exact need to achieve cost-effective conversion of beans to saleable product. The fact that the process does not require a high level of technology, is effectively all natural, and does not emit any undesirable residue into the environment, has facilitated adoption of extrusion worldwide. Currently, extrusion plants can be configured to simultaneously produce full-fat soy, partially defatted soybean meal, and chemical-free virgin soy oil. Dry extrusion refers to the fact that this type of extruder does not require an external source of heat or steam. Heat is generated through friction as the sole source of energy to cook and partially dehydrate soybeans within seconds. As the processed material exits the barrel of the extruder, cells are ruptured, resulting in the release of tocopherols, natural antioxidants. The process enhances the availability of oil, deactivates the anti-nutritional factors such as trypsin inhibitors, lectins, ureas, etc. This creates a highly digestible source of energy and protein for all animal species, especially poultry and swine. Extruded whole soybeans contain, on average, 38% protein and 18% oil. The product can be processed by extruders selected to conform to required daily capacity. The extruder can be fitted with a steam preconditioner to almost double the capacity without affecting the quality of the full-fat soy. The only difference would be that applying steam allows an increase in the moisture content of the full-fat soy to about 10%, compared with 5 to 6% without a preconditioner. To produce high-quality extruded full-fat or pressed soybean meal and oil, specialists recommend using raw soybeans with low levels of contamination with foreign materials. A 9% to 11% moisture content in the raw soybeans is preferred. An extrusion temperature of 154 degrees centigrade to 160 degrees centigrade is recommended, based on optimum digestibility of nutrients, metabolic studies, and performance comparisons. The nutritional quality of soybean products is related to the method of processing. Full-fat soybeans from the dry extrusion process provide highly digestible amino acids, 92.5%, as compared with wet extrusion, 85.6%, micronization, 87.9%, and toasting, 91.4%. Different universities have conducted numerous trials feeding dry extruded full-fat soy to broilers. Incorporating extruded full-fat soy in diets resulted in higher daily gain and feed efficiency compared to solvent-extracted soybean meal with added animal and vegetable fat. Feeding broilers diets containing full-fat soy extruded by the dry extrusion process resulted in significantly higher weight gain and feed efficiency compared to wet extruded full-fat soy or roasted full-fat soy. Replacement of soybean meal and added oil in broilers' diets, 1 to 48 days of age, with increments of either toasted or extruded full-fat soy, is practical, although high inclusion levels of toasted soybeans resulted in lower weight gain. Increasing the substitution level with extruded full-fat beans resulted in a numerical increase in weight gain and an improvement in feed conversion efficiency. This indicated more consistent quality of the extruded full-fat product compared to toasted full-fat soybeans. Optimizing processing conditions is crucial to achieving maximum digestibility of protein, amino acids, and metabolizable energy. This has been demonstrated by many investigators who reported an increase in true metabolizable energy, TME, and a linear increase in the amino acid digestibility of whole soybeans processed by an extruder. The highest TME and amino acid digestibility was achieved at 154 degrees centigrade. it is known that dry extrusion results in the deactivation of the anti-nutritional factors and total rupturing of cells within seconds. In the case of soybeans, as the product exits the barrel of the extruder, the oil is reabsorbed into the meal, producing full-fat soy. Combining the dry extruder with a horizontal press to immediately separate most of the oil produces high-quality soybean meal that retains 6 to 8% of oil. The process produces natural oil, which is beneficial for countries that cannot afford the cost and technical complexity of solvent extraction. Coarsely ground extruded soybeans, immediately processed in a continuous screw press, results in high-quality oil and pressed cake. Extrusion prior to expelling greatly increased the throughput of the screw press beyond the rated capacity. On dry matter basis, the extruded expelled cake contains 50% crude protein and 6% residual oil. Extrusion cooking results in 90% inactivation of trypsin inhibitors, and the low-fat cake can be ground easily in a hammer mill. Rupturing of the cells during extrusion results in the release of natural tosopherols, which contribute to improved stability. I'm quite sure you'd like to know more about soy processing. It's time to move on to full-fat technology. Easy extrusion is easy as it can be.